Mr. Sudhir Jain, who is the senior vice president of a manufacturing of Bira 91. Mr. Jain has expertise in manufacturing, supply chain, strategic sourcing, sustainability, business process and improvement, etc. He was in leadership role in many companies, United Breweries Limited, PepsiCo India, and so on. He is an alumni of IIT Roorkee. Thank you so much, sir, for joining us today. Now, floor is on you. Would you like to operate the presentation, sir? You want me to operate the presentation?
I'll try to share my screen, Satya. Thank you so much.
Wonderful.
Yeah. So please tell me if my screen is visible.
Yep, it is visible.
All right. Thank you so much. And good afternoon to my colleagues in India. And I'm sure there are people in other countries at various times who are awake at this moment. Thank you for all having this patient hearing. What I would like to start with is, you know, talk about a little bit to understand. I just was a little excited when Dr. Kuntal Goswami was making his presentation on food waste. A very interesting aspect of beer, which I'm going to talk about, is that it is an agricultural product. And interestingly, all its waste is put to use. So you don't only make beer, but entire waste that comes out of it is a very good, put to very good use. For example, the main ingredient of spent grain, which comes out of it, is one of the wonderful cattle foods in India. And I would say that this industry in last two decades, especially in India, has really moved a lot in sustainable development programs. So to be honest, we are not experts on sustainable development world as it is, but we have a lot of practices in industry which lead to sustainable development. So I will, I have a 12 minute time. I would try to rush through the whole thing. So what I'm just trying to focus is on water conservation, energy conservation, carbon reduction, plastic reduction efforts, CSR, and ethical sourcing. So these are the some of the topics I would like to very briefly cover that industry is working on. If you look at water conservation, beer is mainly water. So if you look at it, there has been a lot of effort in saving water. I remember two decades back, the beer water consumption for making beer used to be somewhere around in India, average around 1:10 ratio. For making 1 liter of beer, some 10 liters of water was being used. Today, probably the largest manufacturer has averaged 3 liters per liter of beer. And some of the breweries are heading towards 2 liters of water per liter of beer. So that's the sort of improvement that water conservation has brought into this industry. And it has come out with a lot of practices, good practices, processes, and state of the art equipment. So beer has a very good practice that they use a returnable bottle from the market, leading to a lot of saving in carbon footprint, but then it needs to be washed. So such programs, we have a very efficient bottle washer where, you know, the water consumptions are very low. In two decades, a lot of improvements have been made in such equipment. Then we are using reverse osmosis process. Interestingly, in India, because we do not have drainage facilities, so the government regulations insist that most of the all the water should be consumed within the brewery. So a lot of effort has come to bring the water wastage down. And whatever is the last bit of water is used for irrigation within the brewery, for plantation and this. So make it a zero liquid discharge breweries. Then they don't stop here only. We also may are trying to work on making water positive. Whatever we draw from the ground, we are trying to put back more than that, or at least equal to that. So a lot of rainwater harvesting systems have come into place. And we are also working with the local communities in various companies for making check dams, you know, helping them with sprinkle and drip irrigation systems. And soft drink industry, many of them have become, you know, water positive or water neutral. So this has been one of the major, change, and a lot of work has happened on water conservation in industry. If you look at energy conservation, again, the technology has come to a great help. Plus, a lot of focus is now going on through renewable electrical energy, for example, solar photovoltaic wells, plants, and wind energy. Efficient equipment are helping us a lot. And as I said, processes are helping a lot. We are working on techno processes where, you know, we are using various enzymes to consume less heat, less energy, evaporation reduction, high gravity brewing, methane gas, which is generated in wastewater generation recovery, and heat recovery and reuse wherever we are using heat to boil. I'm sorry, I'm running a little fast because 12 minutes are not enough. I can speak on hours on this.
Sorry, sir.
So carbon reduction, for example, now we are working on most of the breweries are moving away from fossil fuels. So earlier it was used to be furnace oil, then coal. Now there is a lot of substitution to biofuels. And we are working on biofuels like rice husk, other husks, then in wherever, depending on whatever the local produce is, if it is sugarcane belt, then we are using briquettes made of out of its waste, which has a lot of energy to fuel the boiler. Then interestingly, CO2 generation, beer generation also leads to CO2 generation, carbon dioxide generation. And we have plants now, we have put in plants inside the brewery to recycle that CO2, not to release it in air, and reuse it back for carbonation of the product. Similarly, as I said, the glass bottles, we use returnable glass bottles. Glass bottle making is a lot of energy consumption. So the lesser we use new bottle, the lesser is the energy consumption. Solar plants I have already discussed, and best practices on reduction and consumption of electrical and heat energy is one of the major factors. Next, we have a lot of work is going on in the industry, not in India even, and even globally, on plastic reduction. A lot of secondary packaging was being done in plastic, or raw materials were being procured in plastics. Now, there have been work going on replacing these plastics. So there are multi-packs coming out of paper. Glued cans is a new concept where you do not need an outer cover, and just the cans are glued to each other. Wrap around paper cartons. Hot melt glue, which is again a reduction of BOPP tapes. So a lot of recycled packing material, etc., are being used to reduce plastic. Coming to the CSR, the industry has started working on a lot of CSR activities. Primary health, for example, the leader in the industry has been working on medical camps, child safety sessions, midday meal program, drinking water facility. In fact, Mr. Satya and I, in my previous organization, was part of Water for People. And we were adopting villages where we were putting drinking water facility and toilets facilities for villages in Bihar. That was quite a successful program run by Water for People. Primary school, adopting government primary schools in the vicinity of manufacturing facilities, or supporting by improving infrastructure and improving providing books, libraries, whatever we can facilitate by to improve the quality of learning. Then responsible alcohol consumption. The entire industry is highly focused on this. So online training, certification for plant employees, strict rules against alcohol consumption within our organization, workshops on responsible alcohol consumption for plant employees, local communities, truck drivers, whoever are within our reach. The focus is on doing these activities. Last but not least, this industry is very focused on ethical sourcing. So for example, things like child labor, fair wages, POSH, you know, prevention of sexual harassment have become our processes. Now we are going to a stage where we are now looking for international certification on ethical sourcing, primarily led by commercial interests because the global importers are looking for these certifications. And this obviously bring a lot of discipline within the organization to make sure that we follow all the norms. So these are some of the highlights and key points I thought I will share. I believe I have not taken more than 8 or 10 minutes.